All right, guys, another Patreon month. The singles you missed last month, we did Papo's Rolling Stone by The Temptations, and we did Mama Told Me Not to Come by Three Dog Night. And the movie, Spinal Tap.
Ooh, dude, it was such a treat for us. Very different than what we normally do. So last month, we did the full Jimi Hendrix debut album, Are You Experienced? Incredible album. Sticking with the theme of debut albums, The Doors debut. Honestly, from start to finish, incredible album. So it's going to be on Patreon. Now, the movie we did this month, we're actually doing Dazed and Confused. Plus,
two more singles coming also, and all that's on Patreon. All that for less than one cup of coffee. Link in description. See you there. Hey, guys. Hope you're having a great day as well as a great life out here.
Great life. Now, Rod Stewart, you saw the title. I know I'm losing you. So for one, we had to hit him again. He's so, so good.
It's been a hot minute. And on the last one we did, what's called Stay With Me.
Yeah.
That song, everyone in the comments said, that was with Faces. Everyone in the comments said we had to hit this one next. I'm losing you.
And now I know every middle-aged, but still young and rocking it, viewer on this channel that is a girl has a crush on Rod Stewart. I know that to be factual because I've seen it in the comments. It has been overwhelming. So,
yeah.
Mr. Rod Stewart, I know you know that you have a bunch of fans.
What's the song I found out or discovered very recently? It's like, it was a rap song. I didn't know it was Rod Stewart.
Oh,
it's the every day.
Dude, in fact, give us 10 seconds. Okay, so this is a song by $APRocky.
ASAP
Rocky. And the fact that you guys don't like rap, but this might change your mind as far as the chorus goes.
Every day I spend my time drinking wine.
Dude, I mean,
waiting here to find a sign that I can understand. Yes, I am.
I mean, it goes in.
So every day I spend my time.
Anyway, so very, very good. So that being said, we're going to go and hit Rod Stewart the proper way. Uncut Rod Stewart. In fact, some might call it Raw Stewart.
Raw Stewart.
This is back in the day how it should be enjoyed. So I know I'm losing you. Rod Stewart, you ready, my friend?
Let's do it, man.
Let's do it.
Ooh.
Dude. Okay. Oh my gosh. Da-da. Da-da. That little bit of like verb on a hi-hat.
They're teasing it.
Oh my gosh. Hey!
I'm losing you.
dude. I mean.
Filthy ending.
That's freaking dirty that is what that was.
And I love how it wasn't like just like a straight halftime. It was almost like slower than halftime.
Well, because it wasn't halftime. They just literally just, it's called retardando. Like they like slow it down. So it's just like ba-da-da-da-da-ba, and they kind of go back to where it was, where it's sitting back in the groove. It's so good.
It was nasty.
It's so good. Oh, my okay.
Goodness.
So every aspect of that. So we'll start at the beginning, right?
Okay.
Came in so strong.
Filled the guitar.
Every element, tonally. What impressed me the most about it is tonally it was perfect. Everything sat so well in the mix. Like the bass had this kind of fuzz on it that wasn't too overwhelming, too overpowering. Mm-hmm. It felt it stand out in the mix because of the fuzz, but it wasn't too much. Like the piano stuff when it came in, I thought it was a little loud, but it still did its job. The guitar came in great. Like the drums came in great. Everything felt so smooth in the mix. Just so
and
ready.
Everything blended very well.
Yeah.
Blended very well. Yeah. The only thing I wish would happen would be if Rod's voice was a little hotter. A little hotter.
Oh, but dude, he's singing so loud. I think any louderness would have been overpowering.
True, but he shouldn't have to fight the keys. I feel like they're overpowering him a little bit.
Dude, I feel like he had to fight everything, and that made him sing better.
I think that's probably true.
Like, imagine him in the studio. He can't quite hear his voice just enough. He's got to go a little louder just to make it. It's like, no, a little bit louder than that. You know what I'm saying? Like, really getting
up
there.
It definitely makes sense. I just don't like hearing my boy Rod getting, like, overran slightly by keys at times. I think towards the end of the song when he's fighting the drums, that's kind of like, that's like primal. That's like feral. It's like, I can dig that. Like,
that's a general going to war spirit. That's Genghis Khan right there.
But, like, I don't want to see, like, Rod getting cucked by some keys. That's a lot.
Rod getting cucked by some keys. Yeah. Put that on a shirt, Rod. You can have that. That's an idea for you.
Just like 11% higher.
I can see it. Okay.
Overall, his voice, like, just in general, like, not talking about the volume, but just the tenacity, like, great vocalist. He almost like just the ideal rock and roll singer.
It really is.
In a way.
Because it's like you have some people, like, I know my grandma does not like how Axl Rose sings. Now, that's not an opinion shared by everybody, but it is an opinion shared by a lot of people. Where it's like, I personally love it. Some people do not, right? Mm-hmm. I feel like Rod Stewart's voice, you can't hate on it.
Yeah, unless you somehow go, honestly, I'm getting tired of the rasp. Like, it feels forced. I could see somebody being like, listen, it sounds like Rod's forcing the rasp a little bit. I don't think he is, and even if he is, I'm going to plead ignorant and just kind of, like, let it happen to me.
It's so good. It's so good.
I dig it.
Yeah, and all the little licks that you're hearing with, like, the piano, and it feels like they create these moments in there that just really, really make me want to go into it. And, dude, don't even get me started on that middle section. The words, like, it all of a sudden sounds like a sea shanty. A home. Like, I feel like I'm about to walk higher to the Caribbean. You know what I'm saying?
Or Wall Street. Either or.
Facts. And it just starts, it's so good.
Then the keys come in with it.
It's just dirty.
Filthy.
Didn't press this, but should have.
That right there? That's a That's a banger. That's
yeah. Right. Especially the last like minute and a half, just that jam section, and you just have like everyone going, oh yeah. Oh yeah. Like in the back. Yeah. Like, dude, it was they were jamming, bro.
One thing that I noticed that I loved is that, you remember when the tambourine came in?
Yes.
It was
it added so much.
More important than you realize.
How so?
Because the drummer now is able to stop getting away from the hi-hat and still be able to jam just as well.
Oh.
That it took the place of it. So you were able to get all this like crazy energy.
They handled that section, so he was able to really go ham on the, like the lower end.
And he didn't, but you still felt like the groove was there, which is usually super. Like their hi hat is like very important in keeping that like timing of it.
Yeah.
So it's like, let's switch it out so we can give you free on the other stuff.
Yeah.
And even when it came back in with like I'm losing you with like the chorus, right? Yeah. Still, he didn't have to go back to the hi hat. He did for a little bit, but he didn't stay there and he didn't begin there because he was able to let the tambourine take over for it.
And the tambourine Jonas added like a chugga 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 kind of like feel, like almost like it just elevated the intensity of the feeling where it's like
incredible.
Where's this going?
Yeah.
It's like climaxing.
Love it. Love
phenomenal.
It. Love it.
Phenomenal.
This is definitely an A plus song for me.
I think so too.
A plus. Oh, okay. So what do we do?
A half plus.
What do we do from Mr. Rod Stewart train collector, the infamous train collector. Remember that?
Infamous train collector. I do remember that. Yeah. You mentioned it one time.
Yeah. So, what do we do next from him? Whether the faces or Rod specifically.
We got to interview him and just talk for like a straight hour just about trains.
Dude, he would do it in a heartbeat.
Like literally make it a point to not talk about anything else.
Anything rock and
just,
roll.
Ever, just trains.
Okay, like when we go to Patreon and be like, hey, we're going to submit questions to Rod Stewart. So ask whatever you want, but it has to be train related.
Has to be.
That's all he loves right now.
Yeah. So. We care about their hobbies.
We do. Listen, these are people too. They're not just like icons.
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, with that being said,
A half plus, A plus,
A plus.
Great song.
Let us know what's next, and we'll see you in the comments. Okay.